Apple completely changed the Photos app on our iPhones with the iOS 18 upgrade, and most people think it's a complete disaster. But not me. Stick around. I'll show you how to make it a dream come true. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and in this video, we're gonna talk all about the new iOS 18 Photos app. There's a lot of big changes, but if you know how to make the most of them, it's actually a good thing. Don't zone out before watching my MacWhisperer Power Tip, where I will show you how to use a specific new tool to help you find that exact folder, album, or person almost instantly. So let's hop on over to the phone and get started. When you first open up the app, you might be a little overwhelmed. It feels like you're in the middle of things, like your photo library is kind of up at the top, but you're not fully in it, and you've got things underneath it like trips or days or other things like that. I don't want you to get overwhelmed. It's actually very, very simple. In order to access your photo library, simply tug down on the photos you see at the top. That will immediately engage you into the photo library, allowing you to view it just like you did before. You can pinch the phone together to make pictures smaller, or spread your fingers out to make it bigger and see your photos in an even better view than ever before. On the bottom left-hand side of the Photos library, you're going to notice these little arrows. These allow you to organize your library in different views. The two most common views you'll see at the top. One is recently added, and the other one is date captured. This is a really important distinction because when we take photographs, they're normally organized by the date the photos were captured. But sometimes we import in an old photo, and then we struggle to find where it is because we don't actually know what date that photo was taken. By changing this view from date captured to recently added, we'll find the most recently added photos down at the bottom, even if those photos were taken 10 or 20 years ago. By clicking this arrow again and organizing it by date captured, things go back to the chronological order when the photo was taken. So separating these two views makes it easy to find an old picture you added recently or a new picture you just took with just a simple button click. Let's come back down into those arrows here and we'll look down below. There's a section here dedicated to shared photo libraries. If you don't know about the shared photo library, this is a powerful tool that can allow you and up to 5 other people to share a library of photos together across all of your devices. For husbands and wives who have been trying to synchronize their photos for years, this is a godsend. I'm not going to get into the shared photo library today, but in a future video, we're going to talk all about it. Down below, we've got something called the filter, and the filters section allows you to organize what you see in your photo library. Either you can see all items or just your favorite item, or maybe you just want to see the videos you've taken. By using this filter, you can quickly jump between different kinds of photographs, including screen recordings or screenshots, making it simple for you to find exactly what you're looking for without even leaving the photo library. In addition to the filter, we've got these view options that are right here that can allow you to zoom in or out, but pinching and spreading does that just as well, can change the aspect ratio grid, which can change your photos from being viewed as squares like we see here, or in their true size as vertical or horizontal rectangles. You can turn it on or off at will, making it easy to change that setting. Down below, you've got an option to show or hide screenshots, which can be really helpful if you take a ton of screenshots, but you don't want them clogging up your photo library. You can also turn on and off photos that were shared with you, or the shared library badge, which again has to do with the shared photo library. Let's look down at the bottom. Here we've got the options to view our photos based on year, which sorts things automatically for you, allowing you to scroll back in time and immediately see pictures without having to scroll endlessly to find them. From the months view, you can easily revisit some of your favorite moments or photos from any month over the course of time. And by clicking on the All section here, you will see all of your photos in their entirety. A little pro tip here, if you're in the photo library and you want to go down to the bottom, press on the All button after you've selected it and it will immediately jump you down to the very bottom. In the upper right-hand corner, we've got a couple of additional options. You've got your Profile button here. Clicking on that allows you to see some of your personal settings, including pictures that are suggested for your shared library, pictures that were shared with you, iCloud links, and other options that can allow you to control your photos experience without having to go into the Settings app. To the left of that, we've got our search option. And the search option is more powerful than ever, allowing you to not just search for a specific person or a specific place, but to add all sorts of things together in common language so that I can say, Julie and Dylan in Hawaii, and have it automatically find those exact pictures for me without having to search around. Up at the top, you'll notice that it found Julie and Dylan and my Christmas 2019 album, which is when I was in Hawaii. So it's located all of these separate pieces right here easily. Now let's step out of the photo library to talk about the rest of the new Photos app. Let's click the X button in the lower right-hand corner to do that. Now here we are on the Photos home screen, where we see our library up above and all of these separate sections, something called trips or featured photos, media types, people and pets, shared albums, pin collections. Oh my God, there's so many pieces here. It's no wonder people feel overwhelmed. They put all of our tools here without really giving a whole lot of explanation. But if you scroll to the very, very bottom, you're gonna see the magic right here where it says customize and reorder. By pressing right onto that option, you can turn on or off any of these sections that you don't like. I don't really need to see the featured photos, so I'm gonna uncheck that. And I don't care so much about memories or trips, so I'm gonna turn those things off. But I use the people and pets section all the time, so let's make sure that that's up at the top, followed immediately by albums and media types. Anything that you don't want, feel free to turn it off or turn it on, or move it around so it's exactly where you want it to be. Once you've customized and reordered these listings, press the X button in the upper right-hand corner, and you'll see that your Photos app has responded to those changes. Here's people and pets right here, albums, media types, etc. Each of these sections, which are known as collections, have their own purposes. For example, the people and pets can identify the people you take the most pictures of and the people you search for the most often. In fact, you can even customize it by clicking right on the People and Pets section at the top and going into the Groups section and clicking Create. From here, you can easily create an automatic group from anyone in your life. Let's go ahead and click on me, my brother, and my dad, and click Add. And within a couple of moments, I've got myself a brand new group of pictures of my brother, my dad, and I together over the years. Make sure to favorite the people that you take the most pictures of, which you can easily do by pressing and holding on it and choosing where it says favorite at the top of that pop-up list. That will put them at the top here where you can organize them and find them easily. And that's one of the big lessons of the new Apple Photos update. Every one of these collections can be organized and customized to make it perfect for you. You can go into your album section here, and if you'd rather have your Dylan picks up the top, press and hold on them, and just move them up to the top. When you come back to your main home screen, there's your Dylan picks front and center. This means that you have complete control over how things look and where you find things. Scrolling down, we've got our shared albums. These are albums that you've shared with other people or that they've shared with you. Down here, we've got pinned collections, which I promise we'll come back to as part of the MacWhisperer Power Tip. Down here, we've got something called Recent Days. And Recent Days is cool because it takes pictures you took recently and collects them based on the day they were taken. So you can quickly scroll back and find that particular day where all the family got together in San Diego and they were all hanging out. And you can even click where it says movie down at the bottom and it will create an automatic movie based out of these pictures, just like this, with music that you choose and your favorite pictures front and center. The Utilities section is another completely overlooked and really powerful tool. Notice they've even given us the ability to find all of my receipts. I didn't create that album, but clicking on receipts will show pictures of receipts that I've taken. If I scroll over, I can find pictures with handwriting or illustrations or QR codes, all sorts of tools, including documents, or even duplicated photographs, making it easy for me to clean up those dupes and clean up my photo library like never before. Down here is one of my favorite collections. It's called Wallpaper Suggestions. And one of the things I love to do is create new lock screens for my phone. What I love about the Wallpaper Suggestions is that it's looked through my photo library and automatically found pictures that will look good as a lock screen and then practically made them for me. If I'd like this picture of my cat Tarzan on my lock screen, one simple click and I'm ready to add it, just like that. Let's go ahead and add it. I think this looks fun. I'll click the Add button right there. I'll click Set as Wallpaper Pair, and I've immediately got a new lock screen just like that. So people complain because they haven't looked around. They complain because it's different and it's changed. But if you learn how to use it, it becomes a work of art where you can customize your photo library to easily find the people you want, the specific albums you're looking for, all the separate different types of media, your shared albums, etc. So now that you've gotten a little bit of a walk around, take some time, come down to the bottom, customize, reorder, turn on and off the things you want or don't want, and start to explore this brand new app. Trust me, investing just a little bit of time in this app will pay you back in dividends every time you take a picture or go looking for one. Now, in just a moment, I'm gonna deliver my MacWhisperer Power Tip, and this tip will make it so easy for you to find a specific picture, an album, or a person without hunting around. It's totally worth the wait. But before I drop that tip, if you got great value or learned something new because of this video, give it a thumbs up. That makes it so much easier for other people to find that video. And if you've got questions, comments, suggestions, something you want to know more about, something you want to know less about, drop it down in the comments section. I love to hear from you guys, and I'll always respond to your posts. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, you're missing out. There's a ton of great information, new videos teaching you how to use Apple products like never before. Click that subscribe button and that notify bell so you're always alerted whenever I drop new content. Now, we have a drum roll. Yeah, there you go. There's the drum roll. And now it's time for the Power Tip. In this video, we talked all about these separate collections. We talked about how to utilize your photo library differently and how to organize this homepage to find what you're looking for. But Apple hid an amazing tool inside of these collections, and it's right here called Pinned Collections. So the first thing I want to do is come down to the bottom here, customize and reorder, and let's take our pinned collections and let's move it all the way up to the top. Why, Dylan? Why are we moving it up to the top? I don't even know what it is. Sit tight, relax, we're gonna get there. If all of these separate sections that we see are called collections, the people and pets collection, the albums collection, the media types collection, then the pinned collections is the king of all of them. By clicking on the modify button to the right side here, you will get to choose which collections you want to highlight in this pinned collections section. You can make sure that your screenshots are easy to find, or that utilities are easy to find, or that recently deleted or hidden is easy to find. But the key to all of it is down at the bottom where it says any collection or album. That means by clicking this button, you can locate any single person, any single location, any single album or folder, and highlight it up at the top with ease. So for example, if I want to come into my albums and I want to make sure that I always have Julie's birthday easily accessible, I can take that and I can move it up in the list so I can find it easily and quickly. I can come down to any collection or album and I can find all my Julie pictures so that it's easy to see my wife in all of her glory and find fun pictures of her that I can share with friends or family or create fun photo books with. Clicking on it again, I can even come down into specific sections like media types and I can make sure that all of my panoramas are easy to find. And then by simply turning off the things that I don't care as much about and reorganizing things, I can make sure that I have instant access to exactly what I'm looking for every time I'm in my photo library. So here I've got my perfect pin collections with my Julie album, my funny license plates, my favorite pictures, panoramas, an easy way to get into people and pets, and even Julie's birthday party from 2024. This makes it simple to get to exactly what I want without ever having to hunt around. And it's just underneath this innocent little modify button. So that's what I've got for today's video, all about how to make the iOS 18 Photos app beautiful and amazing and better than ever before. I hope you got great value out of today's video. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer. And it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I'll see you next time.